Synths, the final frontier. These are the voyages of the starship Lightbath. Its eternal mission, to explore strange new sounds, to seek out new noise and new joy, to boldly go where no synth has gone before. Captain's log, stardate 8675309.1. I am investigating the planet FM, whose inhabitants are rumored to have a complex spoken language.
Such a strange looking planet. Ah, a native life form! Looks like my translator doesn't understand FM. I must return to the ship at once to recalibrate.
Okay, now that we're back on the ship, we will calibrate our translator using this Endorphin's further generator complex oscillator that is designed pretty much around the Buchla 259 programmable complex waveform generator. It features two oscillators, one which can modulate the frequency of the other. Let's listen to just the sine wave output. If we take the sine wave output of the other oscillator and we patch it into the volts per octave of the second oscillator, we get something. We are now modulating the pitch, the frequency of the oscillator that we're listening to using another oscillator that we're not listening to. We're not actually listening. To that oscillator. Right? We're just using its frequency to modulate the one that we're actually listening to. But a module like this doesn't require one to patch it like that. It has switches for different types of modulation. We're going to choose frequency because we're visiting the planet FM, where the inhabitants speak the language of FM that uses frequency modulation. So as we increase this modulation index, it will affect the frequency of the carrier more and more. It's like an attenuator for it. Is what we were missing. And do you hear how the timbre has changed? When it's slow, we can hear the frequency moving up and down. But as we increase, it starts to sound different. So now, the further generator has these knobs that have a huge amount of travel. They're a fine tune and a coarse tune knob all in one. The original 259 Buchla had kind of a normal knob here and a little fine knob here. But we can patch an offset into the volts per octave of the modulator so that we can have really fast, agile control over its frequency. And that is what we're going to need to be able to communicate in any way that doesn't just bore them. I think we're ready. I'll pass this data on to my translator, and when we get to the planet, we should be able to understand what they say, and they should be able to understand what we say. So, here we go. Back to the planet.
Greetings, inhabitant of FM. I come in peace. Thank you, Bork. You are also quite attractive. Please excuse my oversight. I did not bring any treats. My apologies, O furry Bork. I have only pets, but no treats. Certainly, Bork. I will return with treats. Good. Fine.
Evidently, my FM skills are not quite tasty enough for the life form known as Bork. Fortunately, I know who can help. So stay tuned.